Here's how you can create amazing YouTube thumbnails for free with Adobe's Creative Cloud Express, which brings some of Adobe's powerful Photoshop tools to you for free. Things such as removing a subject from its background, image animation, and templates. When it comes to YouTube, thumbnails are super important, and one of the most common tools to create YouTube thumbnails is Photoshop. But with Adobe Express, you can design YouTube thumbnails on your computer and your smartphone for free. And if you'd like to give this a try, you can do so via the affiliate link in the description down below, right above those YouTube chapters. But keep watching this video until the end to see how I created this video's YouTube thumbnail using Adobe Express. To access Adobe's Creative Cloud Express, you can do this on your computer via your web browser, or you can do so via the app using your Android or iOS device. In this tutorial, I will be breaking down everything on my computer, but because of the cloud aspect of Adobe's Creative Cloud Express, everything you do on your computer will sync to your smartphone and vice versa. Once you sign up via the link in the description or download the app via the App Store, you will be brought to the homepage here. The best part about Adobe Express is that there is no watermark on the free version. And if you're not a designer, they have so many templates, as I mentioned earlier, for different creative projects that you might want to try and create. Now, this tutorial is focusing primarily on YouTube thumbnails, but subscribe today if you'd like to see more on Adobe's Creative Cloud Express and other affordable ways to create content. Anyway, you can start creating a new YouTube thumbnail by scrolling through these options here. Scrolling down to YouTube thumbnails, or by searching for YouTube thumbnails in this search box here. I'll click on the YouTube thumbnail option right here. Once it loads, we will see our blank YouTube canvas. From here, I can start by adding any of the design options on the left or right that are free. Let's go ahead and click on templates. The first thing that I recommend doing when looking at the templates is selecting this filter options icon here to expand your view. From here, we'll be able to look at all the different YouTube templates and design styles for this. It is important to note that while it is amazing that Adobe is giving us so much for free, they do have some paid versions of Adobe's Creative Cloud Express. You can get it monthly for $9.99 USD or yearly for $99.99 USD. The paid versions of Adobe Creative Cloud Express do have more options for creativity, but if you are going to go ahead and buy it, I'd recommend doing yearly because it ends up being about $20 cheaper than if you do monthly. If you want to know how you can tell if any option is paid or premium, it will have this icon on screen next to it. So that will let you in on if it is free or paid. You can also filter to only see premium if you'd like, or animated thumbnail options. Since this video is focusing on the free version, I'll only be working off of the free templates. If I look here, I really do like this template, so I'll start with it. I always say to look for templates that fit your YouTube style. Now, if you're new and you don't have thumbnails yet, look at YouTubers in your niche creating the same content that you want to make, and see what you like and don't like. This does not mean you rip them off, but look at what's working by looking at what is ranking in search and which content has a decent amount of views. Then put your creative spin on that topic. If you do have YouTube thumbnail data like I do, then be sure to take a look at your past data and try to recreate some of the styles that have worked for you historically. You can see how your thumbnails have performed by using YouTube Analytics. Just head to your YouTube Studio, select Analytics, then select Reach, and then you'll click on See More here. Your goal here is to focus on which of your videos has high amounts of impressions for your YouTube channel, and then sort by its click-through rate. You can then hover over here to see your past thumbnail design and keep them in mind when you're creating your new thumbnail, like I will for this video. Speaking of the thumbnail for this video, I wanted to focus on the fact that this video is free when it comes to my thumbnail design, since that did well on this thumbnail for me in the past. I also want to show that it's using Adobe Express and highlight that you can use it on both a computer and mobile device. I also want to make it clear that it's YouTube with a YouTube logo. With that said, I'm going to show you how I created the final thumbnail for this video using this template here. I'm going to be talking about a lot of different points, so if I go too fast for anyone, I highly recommend you use YouTube chapters in the description down below. The first thing I recommend doing for any kind of design project is first name it. You can do so by clicking here and then typing or these three dots and then clicking on rename. For this example, I'm just going to call this Adobe Creative Cloud Express tutorial, but I'm going to abbreviate it. You'll then notice that the saving icon is going to be syncing it to the cloud and saving it. As of the time of this recording, there is no manual save option, but I do hope they add that in the future. From there, we can click on the template to see how Adobe Creative Cloud Express kind of sets everything up. It uses a multi-layering system, and so with it, you can then choose how you want your layers to go. You can use this by looking at here to kind of control the layer order, and you can move up to the top or move down to the bottom. You can also just drag and drop which layer. And this layer up here is the upmost top, where this layer is the absolute background. If you want to make changes, you can just do that. If there's a mistake you made and you want to undo, you can click the undo and redo on top. Or if you're on desktop, Control or Command Z works just fine. So that's how you can really edit these to make changes. This is how we started, and the reason I chose this is I like that it had a really good compare and contrasting background color. It had something that split the background and the star, and of course, it shows a computer and phone, which is something you can do with Creative Cloud Express. I want to show the final thumbnail, and I'm going to go to my projects. That's going to take us to the thumbnail that hopefully one of the many you clicked on to get to this video. Everything that you see here is using Adobe's Creative Cloud Express. So I'm going to click on the image itself, and you can see that this has a lot more layers than the first image I utilized. I'm going to break down this template one place at a time, and we're going to start with the text since we've shown off templates earlier. Text is just as it sounds. You can click here to choose some of the predetermined and pre-written text styles, or you can click add text and it will do just that, add text to your project. So the first thing I did was make free really large in a font that I like for my channel, and then I gave it a drop shadow. There are more options here though. So if I wanted to add a shape behind it, something like this, I can do that. If I wanted to give it an outline as well, I can then change how this looks. Again, if I want to undo anything, I'm just going to quickly do that. But a cool thing about Creative Cloud Express is it gives me options to find a new style. It will change the text here to give me different options. Next, I want to show how you can add photos like this YouTube logo and the Adobe Creative Cloud Express logo. Just click on Photos, and here you can search for Adobe stock photos. You do get some options for free. Or you can choose to upload your own like I've done. So click on upload photo, find the file you want to add. In this case, it is the Creative Cloud Express logo. And boom, it is added to your project. If I hover over it, you may notice that there is no drop shadow option. And that's something I'll show you how to do a bit later. I can then choose where I want it. So let's say I want it behind everything here. I can move it all the way to the bottom, and it's basically behind everything. Since I already have it to the image, I'm just going to go ahead and quickly delete it. But that's how I was able to bring in this and this, as well as the screenshots of the videos I have that are ranking in search. Next is icons. So when it comes to the icons, I didn't have as many options as I did with the images, as you can see between these two on the side. So in order to add this drop shadow, all you have to do is duplicate the image by going up here. Then I just change the color here, and I can choose this color that I've already have. And I lower the opacity so that it is actually more like a shadowed image. Since I already have a drop shadow, I'll go ahead and delete it. But I was also able to do that with this YouTube icon. If you want to hide a layer, there's no real hide option, but you can lower the opacity. Design assets are just a little bit more complex versions of the icons, I find. You can find a lot of cool stuff here, but I didn't really use them in this project, but I highly recommend that you give it a shot. Then backgrounds is similarly, if you want to change the background or maybe add a texture, you can definitely do so utilizing these. Logos lets you add your logo if you have one. And then colors lets you change the colors of the image. So if there's different options here that you can kind of go nuts with. Animation will let you animate what you have here, so you can animate the text. So if I wanted maybe dynamic text, you can see different ways that this can kind of come into the image. So thumbnails and free kind of come in that way. I can also change this to pan in if I really want. For now, I don't have any animation I want to add. Similarly to background, I can use this to add a border to my image. So let's say I wanted to add a different layer. That's something I could do. Resize is a premium feature. Because of that, we're just going to skip for now. Now, design is really cool because it allows you different variations of what you have here. So if we scroll down, let's say I want these colors, but I want to keep the same design. You can keep shuffling it and it'll keep giving you different options for designs depending on what you chose. Maybe this is something I want to give it a try. Maybe this is something I want to A/B test. So same ideal, but just different way to do it. As we talk through, we have free because in the past that has worked for my thumbnails. I wanted it to be clear that these are YouTube thumbnails and this is through Adobe Creative Cloud Express. I point to an image that has a high click-through rate because as we talked about a little bit earlier, that's important. And then for the images here, they're just those screenshots and I just added a minor blur effect by selecting this and then making this 3, you can just type that in. And that's really all I did to make this thumbnail. Then I just duplicated the original file here. I added a crop so it's a little more circular and to fit into the phone. Once I'm done here, if I want to download this image, I can just click download and save it as a PNG, JPEG, or PDF. I can also share it. So this will let me publish it to social media. I can invite people. I can use this to make a template. So if I want to edit this for future thumbnails, I can. And I can send this to Google Drive. But you can invite people by clicking here. And let's say I have a friend who's a designer and I want their input. I can click here, put in their email, invite them to either look or edit, and then they can give me advice and feedback on this thumbnail. That's really how easy it is to create and edit thumbnails using Adobe Creative Cloud Express. I do want to call out that if you are familiar with the design industry, that Adobe Creative Cloud Express does seem very similar to Canva's free and premium options, even down to this crown icon to distinguish if something is free or paid. Since I've seen many other YouTubers and influencers say Canva's easier than Photoshop and you'll never need Photoshop again, I can see why Adobe wanted to create their own browser-based designer. So look, however you feel about Adobe's Creative Cloud Express, one thing is true. The competition between Adobe and Canva offers us as creators more free tools. So in the end, we, the creators, are winning. I do want to know though, how do you feel about Adobe's Creative Cloud Express and will you be giving it a try? Let me know via the comments down below. Want to learn more about affordable filmmaking tips and tricks like this? Then subscribe and ring that bell for new videos and streams weekly. So remember, I'm Andrew Can, and if I can create thumbnails using Adobe Express, then you can too.